Bucka bucka. You know the dev.
Hey, welcome to 2K Nola. Make sure as you're coming in, you do like the video. Make sure you also subscribe and hit that notification bell. And make sure you follow your man on IG at 2K Nola. Hope you enjoy the video.
Yo, what's up? We were able to see a lot of exciting things tonight with the New Orleans Pelicans. And in the walkthrough, we were able to see Zion Williamson not only walking, not only running, but dunking the ball. This is very good and exciting for his progress. We hope and he continues on the right path of just getting back healthy. I don't know if you can tell from this video how much he looked like he weighs, but he looks pretty lean to me. He doesn't look fat. He doesn't look sloppy. He definitely doesn't look out of shape. So we're going to hope that he continues to progress, but this was a very exciting night for him as you see him dunking the ball there. Now, this was also a historical night for Jrue Holiday and his brothers. Congratulations, as they are the first three brothers to get on the court at the same time in the NBA in the game. So that was very fun to see, which Jrue Holiday came out with the win. But this was a historical moment. Congratulations to that family. Jrue Holiday hinted at the fact and also quoted saying that he wants to play with all his brothers in the new future on the same team. He hopes that that can happen. I'm sure it's a lot easier to get him over to the Pacers or to a team that they would want Jrue than it is for us to get Aaron Holiday and Justin Holiday. But I know he tried to get Justin over here back then. But now, I don't know, man. Is that something the New Orleans Pelicans should be concerned about, him saying that? Or should we just, you know, look toward just going forward with Jrue Holiday and seeing how things play out? But it's very exciting that the New Orleans Pelicans are getting some wins, man. It is good to see everything but an L on the screen for the New Orleans Pelicans. Lonzo Ball had 13 points. Derek Favors had a double-double. Etuan Moore was efficient again, 11 points off the bench. Like I said, he's been getting more and more minutes, and the Pelicans have been winning. Along with the defense for this team has just completely changed, held another team under 100 points. I think this game ended at, like, you know, 120 to like 98 or something like that. But the Pelicans came out with the win. This was their most dominating win of the season. Of course, the Pacers without Malcolm Brogdon. You can say all type of things, but New Orleans is without Zion. So this was just a good matchup. I like to see when they do things like this, handling the ball the right way. But Brandon Ingram, again, leading the team to a win. Jrue Holiday played his part. Everybody, this was a great, great collective win. Josh Hart got in on the mix with this win. I like this game. This was against two players that the Pelicans have been chasing for the last 3 years, in Sabonis and in TJ Warren. Those two guys, the Pelicans have been trying to get them on the team for years and had no luck. They had come close, I guess, a year or two ago when TJ Warren was available and they only traded him for like a second round pick. What a steal for the Pacers. But this game was a great, great win for the New Orleans Pelicans. I am looking forward to seeing what they do. Like I said, if they win these next two games, they got the Rockets next and they won the Pacers game. So they got a back-to-back. And I hope they can get it done, man. I hope they can outrun the Rockets tomorrow. And Derek Favors has really been a very, very valuable piece for the New Orleans Pelicans. The way he's played, the way he's made these guys rally together, and he's held down that middle, that center position, it's been great to see what he's been doing and see the type of impact just having a physical big can do onto a defense. You know, that's very great to see what he's been doing. This defense did a complete 180 in Jeff Bizdelic's new system that he's put in place for this defense. I'm liking what I'm seeing, and I hope that a lot of people stick around and still have hope for this team to do something special and to do something good when Zion Williamson gets back. So let me know in the comments what you guys think of the New Orleans Pelicans play and how they've completely changed the way they've been doing things lately. The only thing I will say about this team is Alvin Gentry's system once again has so many turnovers, 19 turnovers a game. The one positive, or another positive thing that I do see with the New Orleans Pelicans, is that the free throws have come up. They shot 100% from the free throw line, I think, against Denver. And then tonight they shot over 80% from the free throw line. So that's been a game changer for the New Orleans Pelicans is making free throws. You know, they were at like 64% at one point and just making free throws. They couldn't get in the hole, you know, and that just was difficult to see. You getting easy baskets, I mean easy ones, and you're not making those free throws with the minimal ones that you did get. But tonight they shot over 80%. That was really good. And I'm looking forward to seeing what they do tomorrow against Russell Westbrook and James Harden. That is a very tough matchup. But let's get it, man. Go Pels. Zion progress is coming along. And remember, you start off the new year against the Los Angeles Lakers. And that, oh man, that is how you start off 2020 with the New Orleans Pelicans. Hopefully Zion's healthy, but we'll see, man. But remember, whatever's good for your soul, do that. Let me know in the comments what y'all think of Jrue Holiday's comments about him wanting to play with his brothers. Also, let me know what you think about the New Orleans Pelicans play lately. And then let me know what you think about Brandon Ingram, man, because he's just been killing it. He's just been killing it. That's been the go-to guy. Jrue Holiday has been helping out. Derek Favors, man, he has been helping out on that defensive end. I just cannot wait to see this team when Zion gets back. And you know who has also been very, very consistent is J.J. Redick, just an all-out pro. All-out pro, my guy J.J. Redick. And it obviously shows why a lot of people want this guy on their team. He just doesn't miss. Whenever you leave him open, it's knockdown. And that's a very valuable weapon to have on your team. And with that being said, y'all be cool, be blessed. I'm out. Make sure you like, make sure you subscribe, make sure you share the video. And catch you on the next one. All right, man, I hope you enjoyed the video. But what I want you to do is make sure you like the video, share the video, and come back. Thanks for watching. And subscribe now to 2K Nola. And just continue on this journey with me. I got a lot more stuff coming to you. I'm out. Be blessed.